My mouth is so dry. I haven't got enough water. I genuinely don't quite know what to do at the moment. In my mind, if I get to the edge of the dunes, I'm going to deal with this problem then. In front of me, the sand is darker. It is moist. If I dig down, potentially I could get water. The water's coming through. The water is coming through. Oh my God. That's water. The cap actually filters all of the sand out and just allows the water to penetrate through all the little pores in the material, so it works perfectly well. Okay, I haven't got enough hands to hold the marmot skin open, but if I use the firewood, I created a wide mouth that I can literally pour water into. It might take a while, but that's clean water going in there. It's clean water that I didn't have half an hour ago. And that is a good 2 litres of water, I'd say. That's a good amount. I need to get going. We're back in the game.
Just checking the tracker there. There's a real sandstorm starting to pick up. A sandstorm in there is going to make navigation hell. Sand being driven into your eyes, the visibility is just nigh on zero. One navigation error, because you can't see, could be a complete game changer.
It's intense out here. Definitely not a good time to be out on the dunes.
Stunningly beautiful, but absolutely exhausting. It's skyscraper tall. That's not a building, it's a skyscraper. The wind up here is unbelievable! Absolutely unbelievable! But this feels very, very dangerous now! When the wind pauses, I'm gonna work my way down! The quicker I get down, the better! This is absolutely ridiculous! Just making a few steps at a time. That was an ordeal. An utter ordeal. But kind of cool at the same time. Wow.
Oh yeah. Look at that. It's almost surreal to look around and see sand everywhere and then a big body of water. It's probably a good place to maybe stay the night, hydrate a bit. I gotta build a shelter, get some rest before I tackle the last part of the dunes. It's been a lot of barren land. At least here I'm noticing I've got reeds. So I'm thinking I could build some kind of nest. I think that's gonna protect me from the wind, insulate me, keep me warm. So what I'm trying to do is create a little bit bigger than body depression so I can build the nest in here. God, I like to be across the dunes, but it's too late. It's tough when you don't know where your competition is. You wonder, but I definitely am pushing hard, so I feel like I must be out ahead. Oh. I'm gonna sleep good tonight.
There's a fire, but that must be Matt. I need to go backwards and get out of sight now. All I need to do is stay low in dead ground. From military experience, you're never exposing yourself in line of sight to the enemy And in my case, Matt Graham is the enemy. I have overtaken him. Consolidation is not such a bad thing after all, is it? Yes, 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 yes. The joy of waking up this morning knowing that I was ahead of Matt was just unbelievable. Okay, that's the first time I've been able to see the salt flats. All I need to do now is get down out of the sand dunes, cross that open plain, and I've done it. I've finished.
It's good to make some miles now. Yeah, this is it. The water bottle. It's organic, though. Running the Gobi without water. How foolish is that?
Both Matt and Ed are really going for it now. You know, they're almost neck and neck. If they can maintain this pace, this could be a really close finish.
Yeah, it's tough to navigate through here because it's all cross-graining. It means you're going up and down all the time rather than following ridges. So you have to weave in and out, pick the most efficient route. Sometimes you hit a soft pocket and it's like, oh. And then you hit a hard pocket and you're just like, yeah. So there's a lot of yes and then, oh.
My strategy is to try and maintain height as much as possible. If I'm going down into every single dip and then up every single sand dune, then that's just exhausting. I've got to try and weave my way through the little channels.
These guys have hardly taken a break. They're really pushing it.
I still don't know where it is.
It really is going to come down to a dash over the last part of the dunes.
I've just got to cross this one final step. I think there is every possibility that I've won this race. Matt would have had to cover a huge distance today if he was to overtake me, and I've not seen him.
Both guys are now right on the edge of the sand dunes.
I'd say I could relax, but I just don't know where Ed is.
Well, we should be able to see one of them coming in now.
The end is in sight. Matt is not visible behind me, and he's not visible in front of me.
Ed's just coming up on this last climb now. He's got this one last challenge up the hill.
Good to see you, mate.
Good to see you. Been watching you for quite a while, actually.
Exactly.
Listen, mate. Well done. Really good effort.